president trying to dodge the tax hike bullet to pay for healthcare, but can he? Welcome, everyone. I'm Stuart Varney, in for Neil Cavuto. This is Your World. President Obama today vowing his health care plan will not add to the deficit, but at $1 trillion or more, how do you pay for it? The president says it can still be done by capping deductions for high-end earners. But his own budget director says that would generate just $267 billion, still way short of the $1 trillion mark. Kate Obenshain says the rest is going to have to come from taxes. She's with the Young Americas Foundation, but radio talk show host Nancy Skinner disagrees. Nancy, to you first, if I may. All of the president's advisors, none of them will say that you're not going to have to tax people making less than $250,000 a year. They will not back away from that. They're all saying, basically, you got to tax them.
No, no.
Yes, they are.
The president ran on this, has maintained that he will not have to. And it's funny, Stuart, the critics of this, the president's plan here, were the same folks who put Medicare Part D in, this huge expensive drug, prescription drug, without letting the government compete or try to negotiate for better rates. That's the key to this. There will be a public option that will bring down the cost of this system, and so we will be able to pay for it. There will be a pool of risks out there, 47
Kate,
million Americans, and that pool will make it affordable for everyone, and they'll have a choice.
All right, Kate, what do you say?
I say there will not be a government option. There will be a government system, because the government will undercut private health care industry. That's obvious. And it will become the sole provider, and it will be a lot more expensive than the $1.6 trillion we're hearing about today. But, of course, $200 billion, for one thing, won't even begin to pay for it. But I can't imagine raising taxes or limiting itemized deductions right now. When you look at the impact that's going to have on the housing industry, on deduction, people being able to deduct for their mortgages, but also on private charities, we've already seen a backlash against that idea. And to see the president coming out with that again today, of course he's going to have to look at taxing health care benefits provided by independent. Of course he is. He even handed it off to the Congress, not being able to stand up and say it himself.
All right, Nancy, hold on.
Nancy, I do
have a question for you.
Of the government.
Nancy,
one
of the things the president is saying is, look, he's going to wring hundreds of billions of dollars worth of cost out of the medical system. Can you say, can you tell me any program in the history of American medicine which has ever really taken serious cost out of the system? Can you name one program that's done that?
He's already done $2 trillion worth
no,
of
cost. No, he hasn't.
Since he's taken office.
He has not.
Looked at line by line. But
no,
here,
that was a promise. That was a promise from the drug companies, which was
Stuart,
later rescinded, by the way, Nancy.
Let me answer your question. Competition is the way you reduce costs. And yes, Kate, you are right. When the government...
No, my question, Nancy, was, can you name a single program, Nancy? Can you name a single program in the history of American medicine which has radically cut costs? That was the question. Can you answer it?
Competition will do it. I will tell you that.
Will do it, not in the past.
Because what you do is... Because we haven't done it yet. Health care costs are at double-digit escalations.
Okay.
Nancy, competition among private companies, encouraging that certainly will. It is not genuine competition when the government comes in with its ability endlessly subsidize programs. And look at Medicare and Medicaid.
But Kate,
these programs are getting ready to bankrupt. Can I just finish, Nancy? These programs are getting ready to bankrupt the country. And we're going to model a government health care system after Medicare that is ludicrous and should not even be considered right now when we are facing such economic crisis right now. And for the president to say that for us to argue this point are scare tactics, that is infuriating. Right now, the American people need to look at what a devastating consequence the increased taxes are going to have on our economy as well as on
healthcare. Nancy?
Sure, go ahead.
Nancy?
First of all, you said private companies competing can do this. Well, they haven't, because 47 million Americans don't have insurance. More companies are dropping their insurance because the cost is so high. People are losing their choice. So it's what
so you're
saying is working is not working.
Government health care.
Nancy, I do have
now,
one more very specific question. I have one very specific question, Nancy. Nancy, please. I have a question, another one for you, Nancy. Let's see if you can answer this one.
Okay.
Can you name a single study which looks at the health insurance plans being put out of the House and the Senate, which suggests that the cost of public provision of health care for the uninsured will cost less than $1 trillion over the next 10 years? Is there any such study, Nancy?
How about the endorsement of Walmart?
No, there is not such a study, is there?
The largest employer in the world.
There is no such study.
Why do you think Walmart would get behind this plan if they felt that it would hurt business and their customers? They simply would not, because when you start insuring people, they don't end up in the emergency room. The costs of the system go down. Massachusetts is the closest model that we have.
Oh, by the way, Nancy, the cost of health care in Massachusetts went up 42% since the institution of their reform system in 2006.
It's not the government competing. It's private companies competing, Kate.
Those wicked private enterprise people. Last word to Kate. Last word, Kate.
You're
going to
see individuals and small businesses paying about $4,000 more as Barack Obama and the Democrat Congress come in and start taxing employer-provided health care benefits. Nancy, it is a reality. It has to happen if he's going to be able to fund a $1.6 trillion government-provided system.
Okay, ladies, we had a good debate, and this debate, we know, will continue for at least the next 12 months, and we enjoyed it. Thank you very much, ladies. Appreciate it. Now.
Thank you.